you have the set of n-bit strings, and we want to consider this double string containing 00, that is two consecutive zeros. This is very hard to count, really hard. I mean, literally, that's straightforward, because you may have lots of cases, lots. Especially when n becomes bigger. So what we are going to look here is to define a function that recursively computes the desired number. Do you know what recursive means? Okay, so it means that for value n, the value of the function at n is based on previous values. Okay, so first of all, sign up with advertiser. It says, what's A1? What's A1? A1. Yeah. Empty set. A2, only one possibility. Well, let's say A3. Well, that's different. A3 would be 0, 0, 1, or 1, 0, 0, and F3 is. Now we have the difficult thing here. I'm going to count the number of n-bit strings in terms of the number of n-1 bit strings and n-2 bit strings, right? So suppose I have an n-bit string in AN. So there are two cases for the last character. It may be 0 or 1. Right, so say this is the last position. It may be x equals 1 or x equals 0. So I'm going to consider the case where I have a 1 here, all right? So if it is a 1, how many consecutive zeros do I have here? If it is a 1. So these things belongs to A n minus 1, right? So how many zeros do I have here? Consecutive zeros, like those. You said you knew what recursive function was. Well, it was just publicity. Self-advertisement, self-delusion. Oh, okay. So if I want to count the number of consecutive zeros here, and it ends by 1, the number of consecutive zeros is equal to what? Yeah. And I just remove this and count the consecutive zeros here in a string of length n minus 1. Let's match. Is that agreed? Yes? Okay. So here, that was easy. Here, how do I carry out reanalysis? So if this is a 0, then what's my argument here? Well, again, it depends on the last character. On this, say, Z character. So, this is 0, and this could be 1, on that could be 0. So suppose Z equals 1. Suppose that Z takes the value 1. Then what can I state here? And here? Yeah, because this is 0, this is 1, this is, the whole thing is... So, okay, here. We have this function. That's a recursive function, it has two initial values, and then we have a recursive formula. So n is given in terms of n minus 2 and n minus 1. Next, it says find f of 6. Four. question is taken from a global example where you can have question, mixed question, right? In a partial exam, just get question from the two or three lessons. Yes?
On A3 cannot be 0, 0, 0. It is containing 2 zeros, no? So the f of 3 will be 3?
Yes. Okay, this is wrong, but this is perfectly correct.
On another thing, can you explain B?
Yes.
I don't understand when you are asked there, 1 plus F of N minus
here, F. So I have my N bit string, okay? It may end either in 1 or in 0. If it ends in 1, well, there's nothing to say because I'm not going to generate a new 0, right? So let's suppose x is equal to 0, then I have two cases. The last but one character is either 1 or 0. Mm-hmm. If it is 1, well, it is the same situation, just f of n minus 1. When it is 0 here, I'm adding a new 0. I have 0, 0. So I have all the zeros coming from this part, level 1.
But it wouldn't be. I don't understand because in the first case, sex equals 1 would be fn minus 2 because you are adding. You are taking 2 apart to set 1 and 0. You have your fit string and you have 2 rights at the end, 1 and 0. So you need to have n minus 2.
When it is 0, 1, when the last two characters are 0, 1, obviously this is like n f of n minus 1.
And the 1 you don't count it?
I'm counting 0, I'm counting 1s.
Oh, okay. Yeah. And why did you add 1 plus f of n minus 1?
Yeah, because if the two last are 0, then you have 1 here. Yeah, that's correct. Plus all the consecutive 0 that you have in your A sub n minus 2 set. This is not easy, you have to go over it several times until you get it. It's not something that it is easy. I think that the hardest problem is in the problem set, by far. But you can get something like that, combination of several techniques. Okay, next problem. Just practicing a little bit, use binomial coefficients. Okay. How much? The following event, four cards oval suit for the curve of another suit for the curves of another suit one curve from the remaining suit. Probability of A. Well, of course, that's the only case we have to cover. This is discrete probability, Laplace probability. Laplace is probability. What's the number of total cases? Number of total cases. Or a few preliminary questions. Analyze where I am. Yes, Maurice?
It's four. It's not easy.
Four?
It's not easy.
No. The total number of cases. Can you describe me the total number of cases?
It would be.
I don't mean that. Sorry. I'll reword my question. Describe me the process of selection in this experiment. What do I have to pick? How? So, basic question, does order matter? Yes, so if I get, no, because I'm looking at an attribute, which is the suit, right? Attribute. So, then how many total cases? What? I have 52 cards and I have to select how many? Total cases, not favorable cases, total cases. Have to select how many cards?
It turns 13 to 4.
30 again.
3 times 13 to the 4 times
2. Total cases have 52 cards and I have to choose 13 cards. Does order matter? No, it doesn't, because I'm just looking at a suit. So that is what number? If that means that they have to model. Order doesn't matter. If I choose this suit hearts and I permute everything, I get the same selection, right? Don't I? I'm the same here and the same here and the same here. Right? So I'm not choosing the whole set, just a subset. That's binomial coefficients. No way. So how many possibilities for the first line here? How many possibilities? And now let's go to the favorable cases. I don't like that 4 factorial. You're overdoing it. So first of all, what do I have to do? Choose what? No. First of all, before that, I have to choose what?
Shoot.
Yes. How do I choose it? The suit. I have four suits and I have to pick one. So I pick one. The suit. And then from that suit, I pick four. Right? And now, well, I have to say the choosing of the suit is independent of the choosing of the car. Now I go to the second line. I have to choose another suit. How many possibilities do I have?
Three.
I have, out of three suits, I have to choose one. And again, the team choose four for the cards themselves. And then, another suit. Finally, one card from the remaining suit.
13
choose one, yeah. Yeah, there's just one remaining suit, so there, and that's it. And for your information, this is... But you are not asked that in the exam. Okay. You guys have to practice a lot. Four microprocessors. They are selected from a batch, un lote, of 100. That's my batch. And then are folding. The factory was folding. So, the first probability is none is folding. So I select my four microprocessors and none is folding. How? Yes, Marius?
90 choose 4.
No.
93 choose 3.
No. So, I have my badge.
What is a what?
Lotte. Lotte.
Lotte.
So, what's the quality of being folded? What's the quality of being folded?
One.
Yes. And now, well, the problem doesn't say with or without replacement, but I'm going to assume replacement. I mean, I take the microprocessor and I don't put it back. Right? So here I have like four microprocessors that I have to choose. What's the probability of not being faulty for this? No, that's the probability of being faulty, and they said NAND is faulty, is the component. Right. And so I have taken one that isn't faulty. What's the probability of being not non-faulty now that I took one that it was?
99.95%.
Yes, so now I have 99 in my favorable cases. And how many, total cases? And here I have what? No. Before I had 90 that were non faulty. I just took one, now I have 89, right?
Okay.
If you like, just for consistency, is that better to write it like that?
But one thing, why is it 89?
Because I have 10 that are faulty and 90 that are non-faulty, that are correct. So they are asking me that the
if you in the first choice didn't take a faulty microprocessor, there will be still 99%.
I said that I'm using replacement. I take it and that's it. I don't put it back. So at the beginning.
No, I understand the 99, but the 89, no.
Yeah, because I do one that it is not faulty and I put it apart. So in my. And now I'm going to perform the experiment again. I don't have 100, I have 99.
Oh.
Of which 89 are non faulty and 10 are faulty still. But I care about the non faulty ones. Right?
But the non-faulty, it's the ser 90 instead of 89.
No. So if I want to do this problem with replacement, means in this setting, context, setting. Suppose that I have four different batches and I pick one microprocessor from each. Then I have replacement, right? Because I have four copies of the same batch. In that case, this probability would be what? So now I have replacement. Possibilities for the first batch?
19.
And now?
The same.
The same, yeah, the same, absolutely. Because either I'm talking about four different batches or I'm putting it back. Right? So B, I'm going to carry on with replacement. So I do combinations of both ways. Now B is probability of exactly 140 microprocessor with replacement. So that would be what?
10 over 100 times 9 over 100 times 9 over 100.
Something is missing. Let's say F stands for faulty and C for correct microprocessor. So my choice, my selection is equivalent to find all the four element list formed by with repetition, because there is replacement formed with faulty, correct. What's missing in your answer now? Yeah. Which, well, there are many ways to interpret it. First, I'm going to choose where I'll put my 41, and then it will be this for the probability of being 40. Times the probability of being correct. I have three independent probabilities. If it were without replacement, then we would have 100, 99, 98, 97, like here. It's very important that you read carefully the wording of the problem to find out if you are asking with replacement or without replacement. Okay. So three balls are drawn, and we have three molds, right? So I want you to reflect, reflexionar, reflect. But reflect is also when the light reflects. Reflect on what's the meaning of simultaneously and without replacement. So what's the difference in terms of selecting objects? What's the difference between simultaneously and without replacement?
Simultaneously is all at the same time, replacing is one by one.
Yeah. And in terms of selection, what's the difference? There's none. There's no difference between them. So this problem was here to tease you, to tease Marco Pedro, tease, to make you think about the language. So simultaneous which is the same as without replacement, right? So. Okay, this is mode 1 and this is mode 2. So if I do it without replacement, the probability of A is what? How many total cases? Does order matter? Am I selecting the whole set? Answer those questions, give me the right coefficient. Does order matter? That's the first word, the first question. Why?
Draw.
Yeah, and once I make my selection, if I permute the result, the ballots, do I get a different selection? No, because I'm just considering that color. I don't care in which order they come. I just look the color, right? That's why. Not because it is simultaneously, because it is a color, it's an attribute, right? So. Then, and I'm only selecting 3 out of 12, right? So here, what do I write? Yes. Out of 12, I have to choose 3 with disregarding order. What do I write? For the numerator. How many colors? 2 colors. This is some rule, right? My selection is made on the union of 2 sets that are disjoint. Either color green or color red. So for color green, I have 7/3 plus 5/3, whatever the result is. That was without replacement. And now, with the replacement, so I just draw the ballot, I write down the color and I put it back. Or if you like, the other way to think of it is, I have 3 identical ballot boxes and I perform, I make a selection on each of those boxes. It's up to you. The result is the same, just a different way to think about it. So, with the replacement, how many total cases? solo.
Thank you.
here. Yes, it'll be in Spanish, right? And they'll just answer all the questions. I'll be here from 12 to 1, and if I need to be longer than that, I will.